dog, he'd come back. He likes to smile at us. What are you looking so happy about? What are you so happy about? You didn't want to be in the bush with us, eh? I guess he got tired. Okay, so we're going to charge this. It is completely dead, as you can see. No lights come on at all when I push it. I'll show you just how we charge it. We charge it with our solar in the house. That's why I like this little chainsaw, because we can cut darn near for free aside from our chain oil. I'll show you here. I have a little mess around my battery, so don't mind that too much, folks. Here we are, into the house. Take my shoes off here, of course. Now, that's plugged in to the solar. You can see this. There we go, it's running through our inverter, which runs through our battery banks, which gets charged by our solar panels through that voltage regulator. So now, I just take that 80 volt battery, my chainsaw battery, and I just slide that down until you'll see the lights come on. There we go, it's charging. It's running off our solar, as you can see here. See, that's where that cord runs, right into our inverter. And you hear that fan just whining right out. We are, today it's not super sunny, but we are getting just over 40 amps in our batteries, I guess because I'm not using a whole lot. And to have this old battery in here, I put on charge. That's from the dozer, because my dozer don't charge batteries, so I stuck it in here today. It was really taking charge a while ago. It was taking over 80 amps to bring that battery up. Now it's up to speed. All we're running is the freezer, the battery charger, and some other stuff. We got this stuff in here, the charger for my cordless drills. I got a few of them plugged in, and some other stuff. But yeah, that's what she's taking, and there, it just quit charging. It's up to be 14.8 volts right now. And you'll see when it drops down there. It'll take a while to drop down to where it starts charging again, but it'll take right off again, you'll see. And that's how we charge our equipment out here, folks, the battery equipment. That's why I like that battery chainsaw. We don't have to burn mixed gas in it. It's just a matter of sticking the battery on charge, charging it from the sun through our solar, and we keep cutting. Now, if I could do that with a sawmill, that would be great, but it would take such an enormous amount of power to run that sawmill. See that we're putting in just over 40 amps right there. Okay, well, I'm going to let that battery charge. We will let it do its thing. And Heather and I are going to go out, run some of those logs through the mill. Let's get it started. Thank you. 5 more to go on the trailer. Folks, it wasn't good enough for a 6x6. We'll throw it aside and we'll cut something out of it. Maybe some, 3x4s or 3x5s for the top decking of our mill. I mean, the top decking of our bridge. Thank you. Okay, folks, well, there is another one cut. I'm going to show you what happens if I don't make sure it's against the bunk perfectly. If I get in too much of a hurry, it doesn't cut exactly square. See that? The back's leaning a bit. That's why. I didn't make sure it was against the back this way enough. I don't think my bridge is going to care, but I do a bit. But I'm going to use it anyway. I'm not going to throw it away, that's for sure. Two more left to go, and then we're done. So we need two more for this pier. Originally, we only needed one. But what happened was this one was too small. I will show you what happened with it. It's just too small. I managed to flatten it on this side. I couldn't get it flat on this side. It was too small. Couldn't get it flat on this side either. It just barely touched the first 6x6. But I got two sides. So I'll turn it into maybe some 2-inch or 1-inch or something like that. Probably 3-inch for the top decking of the mill. So there's one on there. The header's probably going to remove very shortly. And then we have, what do we got, 7 here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, yeah, we're going to need two more once she piles this. So there's 7 here. One there she's carrying over now. And then there's two on the trailer yet. Are they heavy, babe, or are they not too bad?
They're not light.
No.
But they're not horrible either.
No. Like, well, they are. They are 8 foot 6x6. Yeah, you can see how that's leaning. I was not careful cutting that one, but I guess when you get in a hurry, that's what happens. You'll be fine for a bridge, of course, but I couldn't see us going out and buying timbers or lumber to build this bridge. It would have been cheaper to get a culvert. But right now, it's cheaper for us to haul out the logs with a little bike and the trailer, mill them ourselves for, a liter or so of gas, whatever it takes. And then we end up with all this for firewood. And that's what I do. I cut these for firewood. Somebody asked me that. But yes, I have a tractor with a belt pulley, and I bring a buzz saw, a cordwood saw, gear saw, whatever you want to call them. I've heard them called different things. I grew up calling them a buzz saw, but we'll bring out the buzz saw. I'll set it up right along here, folks. So I just take my slabs from there. I just pull it this way onto the buzz saw. I cut it. Heather takes the cut wood from this side, the 16-inch, puts it on a trailer, and then we take it over to the woodshed over, right over in amongst the trees there on the other side of the house. Is it showing up? I believe it is. Yes. Anyways. Well, that's it for today, folks. We will talk to you another time. I hope you folks found your way to the playlist I set up on my channel. I hope you're enjoying those. Let me know if they're easy enough to find. I believe they should be. Like I say, you just go to my channel name under here. It says Off-Grid Homesteader Cecil E. Skinner right underneath this video. Click on that. It'll take you to all my videos, and you'll see I've set up a playlist if you folks want to see actually how I built that sawmill. You can see also how I built the set of bobsleighs we haul logs out in the winter. I built those out of scrap parts the same way as I built this out of pieces I found scrounged around. And you can also see a playlist there of us where we started building the house and, you know, where we cleared this land. This was all bush in here. There was a hill, a ravine, and then a hill. And we've slowly gotten rid of all that so we can build our basement there next year, next summer. Anyways, you folks take care. I hope you've enjoyed this one. I hope it wasn't too long and too drawn out and too boring. I will try to edit it the best I can so it's interesting enough for you folks, and I will try to keep doing that. You folks take care, and we'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.